Hi everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how to braze cast iron to steel using a regular propane or map gas torch. I start by positioning the parts on top of this concrete brick, which I'm using to protect my workbench from the intense heat. The brazing rods I'm using today are just ordinary 3/32 inch flux coated bronze rods. Brazing is actually similar to soldering, except for it's done at much higher temperatures. You need to heat the cast iron and steel parts until they're red hot, and that's why if you're using a regular propane or map gas torch, you should only use this on thin, small parts. In addition, it's important to heat up the rod as well. This is because bronze brazing rods need to be heated to over 1500 degrees Fahrenheit to melt, and putting the rod directly into torch flame gets it hot enough. Once the rod and the base metal are hot, you can just guide the rod into the gap, and capillary action should draw it into the joint. If you find that the brazing filler clumps up rather than flowing nicely, that means that the base metal is not hot enough. To solve this, simply heat the metal more using your torch. It's also important to heat the brazing rod as well, but in my experience, most of the time, if you have problems with the brazing rod being lumpy and not flowing nicely, it's because the base metal is not hot enough. It's crucial that you let the cast iron cool slowly after brazing. Never use water to cool it down because that thermal shock can cause the cast iron to crack since it's more brittle than steel. However, unlike when welding, you do not need to bury it apart in sand or anything like that. Just let it cool down naturally with the air. Once everything has cooled down, you can clean the parts. I'm using a drill-mounted wire wheel to remove any oxidation or leftover flux. This also polishes up the brazed joint and makes it look nice and shiny. After cleaning, this is what the finished part looks like. I have this cast iron pipe coupling that I've cut in half and brazed to a steel washer, and there's also a nut brazed to the washer. And this is part of a custom bracket I made to help hold something up in the yard. It is a bit overkill, but I wanted to experiment with brazing cast iron anyways. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it helpful. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you did, and see you all next time.